Inscribed polygon of circle. A polygon is inscribed in a circle if all its vertices lie on the circle. For example, for this triangle, all three vertices, and for this quadrilateral, all four vertices lie on the circle. Or equivalently, the circle is circumscribed about the polygon, and the circle is also known as the circumcircle of the polygon. Triangle inscribed in a circle, or circumcircle of a triangle with circumcenter O. If we consider the circle 1, we can see that the center of the circle is inside the inscribed triangle, and it is also possible that the center of the circle is outside the inscribed triangle or on one of the sides of inscribed triangle. Right triangle inscribed in a circle. If center of the circle is on one of the sides of inscribed triangle, then that side is a diameter of the circle. And we know that the diameter divides the circle into two semicircles, and angle inscribed in a semicircle is equal to 90 degrees, that is right angle. Again, the inscribed angle is equal to half of the intercepted arc, measure of the intercepted arc equals half of the central angle. Considering the endpoints A and C, where AC is the diameter of the circle and AC is the side of one of the sides of triangle ABC, the inscribed angle ABC equals half of the central angle AOC, which is equal to 180 as a straight angle. Therefore, ABC equals half of 180 equals 90 degree. Therefore, we can say that if one of the sides of the inscribed triangle is a diameter of the circle, then the triangle is a right triangle. Radius of circumcircle of a triangle. For this circumcircle and the triangle inscribed, the central angle AOB equals 2 times the angle C. And OA equals OB is equal to the radius. Therefore, AOB is an isosceles triangle and OD is perpendicular bisector to AB, where AB equals C is equal to 6 cm. Therefore, BD equals AD is equal to C by 2 equals 3 cm. And as AOB equals 2 times C, therefore AOD equals C is equal to BOD equals C as well. Now we know that the area of triangle ABC is equal to half of AB sin C equals half of BC sin A is equal to half of CA sin B, where A, B, and C represent the length of the three sides of the triangle, and angle A, angle B, and angle C are the three angles of the triangle, which are the opposite angles of side A, side B, and side C. Now, if we consider the area of triangle is equal to half of AB sin C, we can get that sin C equals C by 2 divided by R from the right triangle BOD. Triangle BOD gives that sin C equals the perpendicular C by 2 divided by the hypotenuse OB equals R with respect to the angle C. So we can write that the area of the triangle equals A times B times C divided by 4R, where R is the radius of the circle and A, B, and C are the three sides of the triangle. Therefore, the radius of the circumcircle equals A times B times C divided by 4 times the area of inscribed triangle. Now, the area of the triangle ABC equals half multiplies base AB multiplies the height CD. We can get the length of CD applying the theorem of Pythagoras in the right triangle ACD, where D equals 90 degrees. Therefore, AC is the hypotenuse. So we can write that CA square equals CD square plus AD square, where CA is equal to 7 cm and AD equals C by 2 equals 3 cm because AB equals C is equal to 6 cm and AD equals C by 2. Therefore, CD equals square root of 7 square minus 3 square, which results in 2 times square root of 10 cm. So the area of the inscribed triangle ABC equals half multiplies 6 multiplies 2 times square root of 10 cm, which results in 6 square root of 10 square cm. As the radius of the circumcircle equals A times B times C divided by 4 times the area of inscribed triangle, therefore the radius equals 336 divided by 4 times 6 multiplies square root of 10, because ABC, therefore A times B times C equals 336, where A equals 8, B equals 7 and C equals 6 cm, and the area of inscribed triangle is equal to 6 times square root of 10. Therefore, the radius of the circumcircle equals 7 square root of 10 divided by 5 cm. Equilateral triangle inscribed in a circle. The centroid of the triangle inscribed in a circle represent the circumcenter of the circumcircle. It is given that for the inscribed triangle ABC, the area equals 25 square root 3 square centimeter. We need to find the radius of the circumcircle. We know that area of an equilateral triangle is equal to square root of 3 divided by 4 multiplies the square of the length of each side, which is equal to A. So we can write that 25 root 3 equals root over 3 divided by 4 multiplies A square, where A represents the length of each side. Therefore, we can write that A square equals 100. So the length of each side equals 10 cm. Now we know that the radius of the circumcircle equals A times B times C equal divided by 4 multiplies area of the inscribed triangle. For equilateral triangle, B equals C equals A. So we can get the radius of circumcircle for an equilateral triangle equals A times A times A divided by 4 times area of inscribed equilateral triangle, which is root over 3 by 4 multiplies A square, and A times A equals A cube. So R equals A divided by root 3. Therefore, A equals square root of 3 times R, where R is the radius of the circumcircle and A is the length of each side of the equilateral triangle. Therefore, the radius of circumcircle of the inscribed equilateral triangle ABC equals 10 divided by root 3 equals 10 root 3 divided by 3 cm. For this inscribed triangle XYZ, the radius is given as 4 cm. Therefore, length of each side equals square root of 3 times 4. So the area of the equilateral triangle XYZ equals square root of 3 by 4 multiplies square root of 3 times 4 whole square, which results in 3 square root of 3 times 16 divided by 4 is equal to 12 square root of 3 square centimeter. Radius of circumcircle of a triangle can also be determined applying the sine rule, which states that the diameter of the circumcircle equals A divided by sine A equals B divided by sine B is equal to C divided by sine C equals 2 times the radius. Therefore, the radius equals A divided by 2 sine A equals B divided by 2 sine B is equal to C divided by 2 sine C. Here, A equals 10 unit, so we can write that R equals 10 divided by 2 sine A. Here, the central angle BOC equals 120 degree. Therefore, the inscribed angle A equals 60 degree. So we can get that R equals 10 divided by 2 sine 60, which results in 10 root 3 divided by 3 centimeter, where sine 60 degree equals a square root of 3 divided by 2. Thanks for watching. Persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from High Study Prep.